So today I just wanted to show you the basics of just threading text frames together. A lot of us use text frames in InDesign, and we tend to drop them on the page here, and we fill them with placeholder text, or we maybe type some text in there. But we don't necessarily thread them together into a story, and in many cases I've come across people who didn't even realize you could do that or weren't aware how to do that. And threading is effectively when you join multiple frames together to form what's classed as a story. And what I mean by that is the text can flow in and out from one frame to another. So if you have a story flowing over two frames and you delete something in the first frame, you'll find text flows back into it from the second frame, for example. And there's a couple of ways you can do that. Method one would be to flow into an existing frame. So you've maybe created your layout, put all your frames in place and laid the page out how you want. And you now simply need to thread them. To do that, just get the black arrow, click on a frame here. And if you click the little white box at the bottom there, the output, you can then click into this second frame and the two are now threaded together. So what I mean by threaded together, if I go to the view menu under extras, I can show the text threads. And when they're selected or when one of these frames is selected, I'll see this blue line linking them together. What it means effectively is if I shorten this first frame a little bit, the text flows into the second frame. And if I make it longer, the text flows back out of it again. So that's what we mean by threading. And similarly, if I was in this first frame and I carried on typing, and we'll just put some garbage in here, what you'll see is when I eventually get to the end of the line, it goes into the second frame and it carries on typing in the second frame. So that's what we mean by threading. The other way you can thread together is when you're creating these frames, you can do it as you're creating them, or you can go into a frame here, for example, if you want to thread that into a new one, you can click the little output and then simply just click and drag your new frame, and that will automatically thread it through to that new frame. So I could click here and I could drag over here, and that's now threaded from here to here, down into this one, then back across to the left-hand page again. So these are all threaded together. And equally, if I was to go in there, fill with placeholder text, you'll find it flows through all the frames in there as well. So a nice, easy way to kind of thread these all together. And you can do that with as many frames as you want over many, many pages. If you want, you might decide to thread together the whole chapter of a book, for example, or something like that. Just be aware when you do that, if you do thread a lot of pages together, you will find small changes, even just to things like font size or paragraph styles or stuff like that, may have a big knock-on effect. By the time you've gone 20 pages further on, you may find you suddenly have two or three blank pages at the end or a whole load of overset text, simply because you've changed the font size by one or two points. So just bear that in mind, have that in the back of your mind. But it can be a really useful trick for working with InDesign.